Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna do a video where I just get ready, but I'm gonna talk through it because we need a talk through video, right? I know you guys really enjoy those, so we're gonna do that today. So throughout the video, there's like something in my eye, so don't worry about it. I don't know what it is. It doesn't hurt, so it's probably just like a little blood vessel or something, but who knows. So that's why I'm not gonna wear contacts. I'm just gonna wear my eyes. And yeah, I hope you enjoy. So if you want to see me get ready and talk through it, just keep watching. Este video va a ser un get ready with me, o sea, voy a hacer mi maquillaje hablando también y a ver qué me sale. Como les digo, nunca los planeo, o sea, nomás los hago y a ver qué me sale, ¿verdad? Okay. So si quieres ver cómo me hago mi maquillaje, sigue viendo. I have a really bad habit of cutting my dead hair. Like, that's why my hair is not even like pretty. It's just like because it's just a bad habit that I have to go in here and just like start cutting random hair like that. It's really bad. But I can't stop. See, I can't stop right now. Somebody take the scissors from me. Okay. I'm going to get my hair done next week. I think on Thursday. And I'm going to, yeah, get a refresher, tone it or something. I don't know. I don't know about hair, but it's just going to get done again. Because it's getting lighter, like, it's just getting really lighter, and it's not matching my extensions very well. So the first thing that I'm going to do, and I'm going to go get some water. I'm thirsty, dude. BRB. So what I'm doing right now is defining my eyebrows. This is something that I love doing first. Do you guys watch Dr. Miami on Snapchat? Because I do, and it's so cool. Sometimes I skip through it because it's like I already saw that butt lift or like that Brazilian butt lift thingy already. But I like watching all the new other stuff he does, like sucking fat from the cheek and stuff like that. So I already went in and did my eyebrows. Ya me acabé de hacer las cejas, lo que voy a hacer ahora. What I'm going to do now is grab this Anastasia Artist Palette, who I forgot about. I've been having it for a little while now and I totally forgot that I had it. So I want to do something a little bit different. I want to grab a clean brush real quick. Okay, just gonna grab a brush and I'm going to get this one called Fresh, PH, Fresh, the yellow one. And I just wanna grab a lot of it because I already primed my eyes. I primed it with concealer and then I put a skin toned shadow all over it to, you know, set that concealer. And it was using this color here. It's hard to see, but it's not white. It's, very skin toned. So I'm gonna grab the yellow. I might get fallout, so like that. And I'm gonna put it all over my lid. You can put it here so it can give you a sharper line if you'd like. But what I really want it for is for that fallout. Okay, as far as my eye, I'm going for a little bruised looking eye, like a punched eye or something. It's just the brown and then that yellow. So I'm going to be using three brushes. This yellow one's the one we used to do the crease. And then there's one more, never mind. Where'd it go? Oh, it's right here. So this one here is just going to be to add the brown to our lid. So I'm going to do that now. And the brown that I'm going to use is from Anastasia. And it's this fudge color. It's called fudge. It's a very rich brown. So I'm going to grab it and then just put it on my lid real quick. Just patting it on. But at the same time moving it up slowly. It's a little sloppy, but I just want it on there right now. So then, same brush, I'm just going to soften the edge real quick. Trying not to move it up so much. And I'm going to go in with this brush here and grabbing some of the yellow on my brush and then moving around that edge again. This is where you're just gonna play with the colors back and forth until it looks just right for you. Okay, I changed my battery, but I was just looking for the charger. And then I saw my hot Cheetos, so now I feel like eating hot Cheetos. But let me show you this really cute cup that I got at the Michoacana yesterday. It's so cute. I can't wait to drink coffee out of it. I used to be in ceramics when I was in high school, and I loved that class so much. And, like, I should have done this. Like, what was wrong with me? It's, like, a long cup, and then I need to wash it. But how cool are these flowers? Like, very, very genius. And I love this, and I can't wait to drink coffee out of it. Back to the video. So I already primed my face. I'm just going to add a little bit more since it's in my hand already. Just here, problem areas are these. I need to go to the store. I need to go buy, like, more nose strips and just more stuff. That's just what I tell myself, but I just really just want to go waste money. But I'm still trying to work on my face routine. I just kind of, like, want to record it in the restroom. But mine's going to be, like, a real get ready, like, get morning ready with me, because ain't nobody got time to wake up in the bed, like, and then go drink your coffee. You know, all the videos that I've seen is, like, do you really do all that every single day? Because I can barely, like, open one of my eyes, and I'm like, can I sleep for 10 more? Like, I don't know how they do it. I mean, that's what they do all day, you know, at home. They don't go to an actual job, but it's like, do you really do that? Let's go ahead and do my eyeliner. I'm going to go for a very sharp, medium-sized wing, and, you know, thickness-wise, medium thickness too. I'm going to use NYC Liquid Liner. I always use this. It's 887, I think. Yeah, 887. Don't get the pearlized one. The pearlized one sucks. It has to be just the black one. Oh my god, people. Did I tell y'all that I got a mailbox? Well, I told Snapchat and Instagram, but I haven't told YouTube. Which a lot of you follow me on everything, so you know, but I have a mailbox now. It's like a P.O. box, but it's an actual street address, so go ahead and I'll put it down below so you can, like, send me whatever you want to send me. If it could be, like, a little letter, it could be, like, a picture of you, it can be whatever you want, and I'll definitely look at it, and I'll most likely reply, because I love letters, and I love sending letters, and yeah, if I ever have, like, extra of something, I would love to send it out to you. So I'm excited about that. And also, okay, so now we want to work on the face. I think I'm going to end up using L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. I've been learning to like it. I don't know why. I'm really looking forward to the Afterglow, I think it's called. I don't know, the glow version of this, the dewy version of this. I still need to go to the store and look for it, but I'm just very lazy. I might. Dang, that red looks really ugly, doesn't it? But it gives me character. Okay, I'm gonna grab something for my nose. This will work. So now I want to set my face before I start creasing here, because I already see a little crease coming out. So I'm going to grab my Laura Mercier translucent powder. I'm just trying to finish it. I would use my Airspun, but I'm here. And then my nose. Oh, that was a lot. But use the rest all over your face. So, the lipstick that I just got from the store, it's a Wet n Wild lipstick, and I don't think I have this one, so I got it, and it's called Pink Sugar 900B. Yeah, Pink Sugar. Okay, let's open it and see if it's pretty or not. It looks nude, so. And these are like $1.99. Oh, it's pretty. It's very nudie. Let's try it. I like it. I'm definitely gonna go in with my favorite lip liner. You know what it is. Elizabeth Arden. Oh. Taupe. Elizabeth Arden Taupe. I'm just gonna give it a quick line. There. Like that. I'm not gonna go in there because I wanna get as much of the color as I can from the Wet n Wild lipstick. So I'm just gonna move it in here. Whoa. It looks very nudie. It's pretty though. Okay, so as far as my lip liner, I'm gonna go with a clean brush and I'm gonna mix it up. I'm just gonna grab a little brush like this. This is Harlot Cosmetics. I'll do a video on all the brushes because, oh my god, brushes are beautiful. I love brushes. Anyways, I got a little bit of yellow. And I'm gonna add a little bit here. A little bit. Okay, so now that we have bottom mascara on here, I'm gonna add my highlight, the best part ever, right? You've seen me do it. I use What's Up by Benefit. It helps me like know where I want it and then just add the highlight itself, and it like kind of lets it stick to it, you know. I'm gonna bring it down here, a little bit on the nose, a little bit on the cupid bow, and again over here. I'm gonna put some here. I'm gonna put some here. I'm gonna blend that out in a little bit. I like to blend it with my fingers first, and then I know sometimes I get told that you never use blush, and it's because I'm scared of blush. I don't want to look like a payasita, you know. So I'm gonna grab a little bit of this blush from the Maybelline contour little palette thing. It's like a baby pink type of pink, and I'm gonna use a little bit of it here. Not going crazy, just to give me more color. Right when I was looking for the brush, my SD card got full because my dumbass forgot to, you know, change or delete what was on it, so it got really full. But anyways, I found the brush, and this is the Anastasia brush. Like I was saying, we're gonna use the Anastasia highlighter, the So Hollywood one. I still love this one. I think it like lasts a little bit longer than Becca Champagne Pop, because I've dropped this like 50 times and it's still good. It doesn't break on me. And let me just go in here and add more highlight, because you can never have enough. I feel like I forgot something. But either way, we're just gonna roll with this, and this will be the final look. Yes! Now I'm just gonna work on my hair. I'm gonna probably curl it, add extension. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm gonna try and get out more videos soon. Today is Sunday. Today is Father's Day. Don't just make it today as your Father's Day. Make it every day Father's Day. Appreciate your dad every single day for me. All the mothers that are fathers out there, you know, appreciate them even more because they're doing two jobs. And I've seen it way too many times where you know, you have a father who's there and you feel like it's not there because they're always working, or that you don't feel appreciated, or they tell you mean things. But just for me, please appreciate them, that they're there, that they're working hard for you, and they deep down they love you so much. I promise you that. And just appreciate them for me, because not a lot of people have them, and they wish they had them. The only thing that I have is a picture. This is my mommy, this is my sister, and then this is my dad. I didn't want to get too personal for YouTube, but, you know, can't help it. I would consider you guys my friends. So when I was one, my dad went to heaven, and so my mother has been my mother and my father. Therefore, I really want to encourage you to appreciate your father so, so much for me. Just keep that in mind and appreciate them, even if you feel like they're never there for you. I promise you that they love you. So, yeah, appreciate that for me. And so, básicamente lo que estaba diciendo ahorita es que hoy es el Día de los Padres aquí según en los Estados Unidos. So, les quiero pedir que por favor aprecien mucho a su papá si lo tienen con ustedes. Yo he visto muchas veces cuando muchachas no aprecian a sus papás, los tienen en su casa y no son tan apreciativos como lo deberían de ser. Ellos hacen bastante por ti. Yo sé que a veces te pueden decir cosas feas o nunca están en la casa. ¿Por qué? Porque están trabajando, seguramente, ¿no? Solo sepan que ellos los aman, te quieren mucho, hacen todo lo que hacen por ti. Y por favor, aprecienlo. Lights are very bright, okay? That's why it's like getting me watery-eyed. No, but lo que estaba diciendo es que yo no quería ser tan personal aquí, pero yo las considero mis amigas. Y yo sé que, me entienden, y yo sé que muchas por ahí también están en mi situación similar. Entonces, lo único que yo tengo es a mi mamá. Mi mamá es mi mamá y mi papá. Pero también tengo mi papá, que él falleció cuando yo tenía un año. Entonces, perdón. Y no es de que yo me ponga así bien triste, ay, no tengo papá, ¿me entiendes? Yo tengo una mamá muy, muy, muy fuerte que vale por 20 papás, ¿me entiendes? Pero me da a veces coraje cuando no, me da mucho coraje cuando veo que no aprecian a sus padres y no sé, así me siento yo y no lo puedo evitar. So yeah, I didn't want to make this all a sad story or whatnot. It's not a sad story because I'm very, very blessed. I'm so thankful for everything that's happened in my life. Everything happens for a reason, so don't ever forget that. Yeah, I hope you have a great weekend. I don't want no type of sympathy or anything like that. I'm very happy, I'm very blessed. God knows why he does things, so all I ask is for you to appreciate everything that you have in your life and be very happy. Go tell your parents that you love them. Tell them every single time you have a chance to. Do it every single day. Don't I will see you pretty much next week. Maybe I'll have a video next week. I need a all right, so let's end this video with music. Bye, guys. Jugaste con mis sentimientos y es lo que más me duele. Por culpa de tu traición, hoy mi alma se muere. Take your time. Mientras tanto, cuídate y que te bendiga Dios. No hagas nada malo que no hiciera yo. It looks like it hurts, but it doesn't hurt at all, I promise.